Ms. Rachel Long.
Chairman, may I have permission to take both my cards together?
Yes, please.
First, on bilateral relations with Malaysia. Singapore shares strong ties with Malaysia beyond economic, defence and trade, to our people-to-people interactions and social relations. Our interdependencies in the areas of jobs, food and water supply, transport links, tourism and trade have only been further magnified in the last year from border restrictions arising from the pandemic. There are two concerns I would like to raise. The first, reopening of borders with Johor. Prior to the pandemic, travellers using the causeway between Johor and Singapore averaged over 300,000 per day, with over a third being Malaysians who commute daily for work and study. Since the movement control order in March and the suspension of the reciprocal green lane, movement has been reduced to travel under the PCA and commercial vehicles. This has a multiple impact on trade, tourism, and also social ties between Singaporeans and Malaysians with family members across the border. With the rollout of the vaccination programs in Johor and Singapore, I would like to ask the Ministry if there are upcoming plans to reopen borders with Johor. The second is the high-level interactions with Malaysia. Regular and active exchange of visits between our political leaders have in the past helped our leadership on both sides develop relations and better understand each other. These exchanges are important to set the tone and overall direction for our bilateral relationships. The COVID-19 pandemic and border restrictions have effectively put a halt to these physical interactions. How have these impacted our high-level interactions with Malaysia? May I continue with my second card on bilateral relations with Indonesia? Indonesia is one of our closest neighbours. We have a deep and multifaceted relationship that is rooted in mutually beneficial cooperation across multiple sectors. Similarly, our regular physical exchanges have been disrupted by COVID-19. It is essential that we maintain the close linkages between Singapore and Indonesia so that we're ready to emerge stronger from the pandemic, which has impacted both our economies. Singapore's economy contracted by 5.08% in 2020, while Indonesia's contracted by 2.07%. Nonetheless, Singapore remained Indonesia's largest foreign investor in 2020. We also rank among each other's largest trading partners, with Indonesia ranking number 6 among Singapore's top trading partners in 2020 and a merchandise value of $48.8 billion. It's encouraging to note that we continue to collaborate on key economic projects, such as the Industry 4.0 program. May I ask how the Ministry has sought to build on the Singapore-Indonesia relationship over the course of the COVID-19 pandemic? How will our two nations work together to overcome the challenges posed by COVID-19 and maintain essential connections and economic links?